not somebody who reconciled themselves with war. And so I only have a couple of minutes, and what I wanted to do was actually read a quote from Muhammad Ali that he said almost 40 years ago to the day. And I want Barack Obama to think about this quote and understand why I believe so strongly that his Ali privileges need to be revoked.
All right.
This is what Muhammad Ali said. He said, "Why should they ask me to put on a uniform and go 10,000 miles from home and drop bombs and bullets on brown people in Vietnam while so-called Negro people in my hometown Louisville are treated like dogs
Amen.
And denied simple human rights?
Right.
No, I'm not going 10,000 miles from home to help murder and burn another poor nation simply to continue the domination of slave masters of the darker people the world over. This is the day when such evils must come to an end. I've been warned that to take such a stand would cost me millions of dollars, but I have said it once and I will say it again. The real enemy of my people is here. If I thought the war was going to bring freedom and equality to 22 million of my people, they wouldn't have to draft me. I'd join tomorrow. I have nothing to lose by standing up for my beliefs. So I'll go to jail. So what? We've been in jail for 400 years.
Amen.
Now, you replace Vietnam with Afghanistan, and this is a message that not just Barack Obama, but the troops need to hear. Real courage involves resisting this war. Real courage involves joining organizations like Iraq Veterans Against the War. Real courage involves putting down our arms and not continuing the domination of the United States and the parade of empire the world over. But I'll say one other thing. This is not about waiting for another Muhammad Ali to rise up and lead us somewhere. Like the great Eugene Debs once said, if I could lead you into the promised land, that means I can lead you out. We're not looking for great leaders. We're looking to create the kind of movement that inspires people to stand up and say, hell no. We are looking to build the kind of movement that can actually reclaim Muhammad Ali from the warmongers in the White House who would use his image to sell a war that will create more orphans than peace. This is the struggle of our lives, and we have to recognize that Barack Obama is actually on the other side of the barricade. So I'll say it one last time. Barack Obama can have the fawning media, he can have the adoring generals, he can have the praise of the RNC for his Nobel speech, but you know what he can't have? He can't have the champ. He can't have Muhammad Ali. Remove that poster from your wall, Mr. Obama. Your Ali privileges have hereby been revoked. Thank you very much.